Hello everyone. The topic for today is a continuation of the last lecture on face modulation. In this session, sinusoidal and digital face modulation techniques are explained using mathematical expressions and pictorial representations. Before going into our topic, we shall define what is meant by phase shift. Okay, so now just consider here, we have considered two signals over here. I've shown the two signals in two colors. Now you can find that these are two similar signals of same frequency and same amplitudes. But you find that the signal in green is lagging the signal in blue by a particular angle. So here you find that is lagging by 90 degrees. So over here you had the peak over here. At that time the signal has just started. And now here it is completed one half cycle. By that time you find this has reached only one half of a half cycle. So here you find that these two signals, if you look into these two signals, this green signal is lagging this signal shown in blue color, or this particular signal shown in blue is leading the signal shown in green color. Now this difference is what we call as the phase difference. So when we express phase difference, you say that a signal is lagging or a signal is leading with respect to some other thing. Now this is the same concept that we use in defining phase modulation. Now these two signals, since they have a phase difference of 90 degree or pi by 2 radians, we say that these signals are in phase quadrature. That is, they differ by a phase difference of 90 degrees. Now we shall see the mathematical expressions for a sinusoidal phase modulated wave. Now we know that in a phase modulator, we have got two inputs. One is a modulating signal represented by EMT and the other is a carrier signal which we represented as ECT. Now ECT is EC sin omega CT, EMT is EM sin omega MT. Now as per the definition of phase modulation, we define phase modulation as change in phase of the carrier with respect to the instantaneous phase of the modulating, with respect to the instantaneous amplitude of the modulating signal. So I repeat, change in phase, instantaneous phase of the carrier with respect to the instantaneous amplitude of the modulating signal. Now we know that in the last lecture we have defined phase modulation. We know that it is one form of angle modulation. So this deviation actually happens over here in this angle. So this is where the change happens. In phase modulation, we know that the amplitude remains a constant, or phase modulated wave remains a constant. The frequency also remains constant. The only change is in the phase angle. So, or this phase shift. So over here, since it is varying with respect to the instantaneous amplitude, we can write here as KEM sin omega MT. This is our modulating signal. So the phase varies with respect to the instantaneous change in the modulating signal. Now this term is what we define as phase deviation. So you might remember such a term in the case of FM modulation also, where we defined frequency deviation. But now over here, since this is phase modulation, we define this term as phase deviation. Now the peak phase deviation, this is phase deviation KEM sin omega MT. The peak phase deviation is obtained when sin omega T is equal to 1. That is the highest value or the maximum value which sin can take. So when that is equal to 1, you find that this phase deviation becomes K into EM. So this phi M or the peak phase deviation is given by KEM. Now substituting this onto this expression for phase modulated wave, you get EPMT is equal to EC sin omega CT plus del phi, just made the substitution over here, del phi sin omega MT. Now this is the mathematical expression for a phase modulated wave. Now if we compare this expression with the expression what we have seen for a frequency modulated wave, we find that the expressions are almost very similar. The expression for the phase frequency modulated wave was EC sin omega CT plus MF sin omega MT, where we said that MF is the modulation index for frequency modulation. Now here in phase modulation, we find that this MF has just been replaced by del F, which we say as the phase deviation, or this is the phase modulation index in phase modulation. This del f over here is similar to your MF, or it is same as the modulation index in phase modulation. Now we will be having a doubt as to what are the components, frequency components present in this phase modulated wave. So in AM we know that we have just got two sidebands and a carrier. In the case of FM, we have studied that you have an expression. Now this is also a similar expression. In FM, the expression is a sine of sine function, which you cannot just simplify just like that. You use the Bessel's function, and finally you get that you have a number of upper side bands and a number of lower side bands. So in the same way, in phase modulation also, if you just look into the final expression of a phase modulated wave, you find that the expression what we get from direct substitution is, you find it's a sine of sine function. So just like the FM modulation case, here also you can simplify it by using the Bessel's function. The last lecture on frequency modulation and Bessel's coefficients and Bessel function will give you the details of all those. So this is the same thing as what we have explained in the case of frequency modulation. So in phase modulation, here you find that you will have a number of sidebands just like the case of FM modulation itself, and the number of sidebands will depend on the modulation index. So from the Bessel's table, if you want to get the strength of the magnitude of the sidebands, in that case you can just consider the same table itself, where we have the table where we give M for different values of MF or the modulation index of FM modulation index, you have got different number of sidebands with significant amplitudes. So similarly, this MF is same as your del F. So what is the value of your del F? Accordingly, that will determine the number of sidebands with significant amplitude. So it is exactly the same. You'll find that the simplification or the number of sidebands depend on the phase deviation over here, just like the number of sidebands depending on the modulation index of FM, MF in the case of FM. So that's about sinusoidal PM. So the expression, it's almost the same as that of FM. And what we call as phase deviation is K into EM, which is very similar to our MF as in FM. Now this is the pictorial representation explaining the concept of sinusoidal phase modulation. So here we have a modulating signal, which is a sine wave, and then this is a PM modulated wave. So what you can see over here is that when you do not have a modulating signal, that is when the modulating signal is zero, that is you do not have a modulating signal, at that time you find that here you have zero phase difference. So the carrier, whatever is the phase of the carrier, you have here zero, same phase or the same signals coming over here in as the output of your phase modulated wave. Now when the amplitude of the carrier, amplitude of the modulating signal increases, now as per the definition what we have learned is that in phase modulation, when the amplitude of the carrier's amplitude of the modulating signal increases, the phase of the carrier will vary according to the amplitude. So when amplitude increases, what you can find is that your signal, the PM modulated wave, will lead the carrier. That is the reason why you can view it as a decrease. You can see it as a decrease in frequency. That is, the signal is leading the carrier signal. So this is what is actually observed as decrease in frequency. Now at this point, again, you do not have a carrier, so it's the same phase shift as that of the carrier itself. No phase difference between the carrier and the modulated wave. Now again, when the modulating signal decreases in strength, you find that there is a corresponding change in the phase shift of the modulated signal. So when the modulating signal strength decreases, you find that you have a deviation which is negative. And when the deviation is negative, what you can observe is that it's actually the modulated wave will lag the carrier. Modulated wave will lag the carrier, or it can be observed as an increase in frequency. So this is exactly what we have learned in the last session. We have said that phase modulation produces frequency modulation. So when we have phase modulation, we have seen the expressions where for a phase modulation, we'll have the corresponding frequency instantaneous frequency for a phase modulated wave. So here you can say that when you compare it with an FM modulated wave, in FM modulated wave we found that when the amplitude of the modulating signal increases, the frequency was increasing. It is just the reverse in the case of phase modulation. Amplitude increases, you find that the frequency is decreasing. And then when the amplitude decreases, in FM modulation, frequency was decreasing, but here in PM modulation, you find that the frequency is increasing. So this is actually giving you this concept of sinusoidal phase modulation. That is, when the amplitude increases, you find that your PM modulated wave will lead the carrier. That's the reason I've showed you that phase shift, the concept of phase shift in the first, just before beginning this. So you have got two signals of same amplitude, same frequency. And now what is happening is that there is a change in the phase shift between the two signals. So here you find that the phase shift varies according to this particular strength. Again, here you find that the phase shift varies according to the strength of the input signal. So this is the example, or this is how you understand, this is what you mean by a sinusoidal phase modulation method. Now, corresponding to sinusoidal phase modulation, if your input signal is a digital signal, you can say that the phase modulation, what you do is digital phase modulation. Now, here we have taken the case of a very simple digital signal which has just got two levels only. The signal at any time, just like a square wave, you have only either plus V volt at any time or minus V volt. So it is just a two level digital system or a digital signal that we have taken. Now this is our carrier signal, or this is the mod phase modulated signal that we have. So carrier, as you know, it will be a signal which is having a particular particular frequency and an amplitude. Now what we have over here is, this is a phase modulated wave where you can find that as you have just two signals, unlike the earlier case of a sinusoidal wave, you have only two amplitudes or two values in your modulating signal. So what we have over here is that when you have plus V, you can find that it is in phase. And when you have minus V, you find that your signal, your phase modulated wave is out of phase with the carrier. So 180 degree is out of phase, what we say, or phase reversal. So you find that at any instant that you take, it is either in phase or out of phase. Now this is what we can actually observe over here. So this is your carrier signal. This is a phase modulated wave that we have, which is actually exactly in phase with the carrier. Now over here, you find that the input modulating signal actually reverses over here. It becomes minus V. So there is a phase reversal happening over here. Now the signal was supposed to go like this, but then there is a phase reversal and then the signal again continues. Now here again, from minus V, it makes a change to plus V. So this signal again, the phase modulated wave changes the phase here by 180 degree and then so on. So what we find over here in the case of a digital signal, or this can be best called as binary phase shift keying. You have just two phase shifts over here, either 0 degree, it is in phase with the carrier, or 180 degree out of phase with the carrier. Now mathematically you can just show them like this. EPMT, the phase modulated wave, is either EC sin omega CT, that is when it is in phase, that is the phase shift is 0 degree, or EC sin omega CT plus 180, that is when the phase shift is 180 degree. So in this session, what we have seen is, we have just defined, we have seen what do you mean by a phase shift. How do you define phase shift in a signal? What is meant by sinusoidal phase modulation? So in sinusoidal phase modulation, we have defined what is sinusoidal phase modulation. What is a mathematical expression for representing a sinusoidal phase modulated wave? And then we have again seen that that expression is very similar to that of a frequency modulated wave. And again, we have seen that instead of a sinusoidal wave, if you give a digital wave, a digital signal as a modulating signal, in that case, the output what you get will be a digital phase modulation. So in digital phase modulation, we have also seen a very simple system which has got just two levels. So this concept of phase reversal has also been introduced in this session. So thank you.